Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel Intentional Living Space. I'm your friend Purvi and I make weekly videos on minimalism, intentional living and self-development topics. If you're new to my channel, I'm really glad that you stumbled upon this space, and if you are back, I am so happy that you have come back. Please guys, subscribe to this channel, share it with your friends, like and comment on my videos so I am motivated to bring to you new and unique concepts every week. And without further ado, let's move on. So recently I was cleaning up my bookshelf. Now since the time that I have moved to the e-books, I barely visit my bookshelf where I keep all the hard copy books. And once, I was cleaning it and I saw in front of my eyes an entire set of an encyclopedia that I had purchased about 15 years back. And since last 10 years, I have not even opened a page of that book. And when I was, cleaning it, a lot of emotions were going through my head. Like every time I saw those books, I felt very guilty. Like, oh, I have not even opened a single page and read it. I also felt very annoyed because it was occupying so much space in my bookshelf and I was not able to do anything with it. And I also felt very helpless because I was not able to let go or think of, donating or decluttering it. So friends, do you face these kind of things, when you encounter possessions that you have not been using since a long time? We all do. So I'm really happy that I stumbled upon a very nice concept that I want to talk to you about today, which is called the silent to-do list. Now this particular term was coined by a Japanese author called Fumio Sasaki, okay, who has written a beautiful book called Goodbye Things, which is like the perfect book if you're starting out a journey on minimalism. In his book, he wrote this particular note about goodbye things, which is perfect and very much relevant to our current situation. So what he said was, every morning, everyone makes a to-do list, right? We make a task list that we need to accomplish these particular tasks through the day. After our tasks are done, we check the things off the list and we feel great. We feel motivated, we feel productive, we feel successful. We just feel great because that burden has come off our minds, correct? So when it comes to those things, definitely we are all aware of to-do list. But are you also aware that the things that you keep in your house, the things that you own, are also building up their own to-do list in your head? Yes, they are. So the author said that everything that you possess is sending out messages to you. Just let me help you illustrate with some examples. So we all are guilty of this. Blazers and dresses that we have purchased long time back that has not seen even the sunlight. Kitchen appliances that we have purchased, like a toaster, a microwave, a rice cooker, and fancy things like a bread maker. We have bought it thinking that we are going to utilize it one day and create amazing dishes, but not once have we utilized them. Gym equipments like maybe a treadmill, which has now become a piece of furniture and you can hang your clothes there to dry. We haven't utilized that. So many hobby and passion equipments, like, it could be a skateboard, a guitar, art supplies, so many things. In our lives, we accumulate so many of these things thinking that one day we are going to use them and they are going to make us a better person. The purpose with which we bought them, that purpose never gets served because we don't even look at them. And every Diwali, like every Indian knows this, we open up our, cupboards, clean everything and put everything right back. So we are actually carrying with us an entire silent to-do list in our heads of the things that we have bought, but we are not utilizing. And every time we look at these things, they communicate to us. They send out messages to us like, you have put my money in me. You have put your space and energy in me, but you're not using me. And we feel guilty and uncomfortable and all sorts of things, those emotions surge up. So the very purpose of this whole concept is understand whether the current thing, which you are not using, is it fitting? Is it relevant to your lifestyle and values at the current moment? Are you going to rekindle your passions and start using that appliance or that equipment? If yes, please start to use it. And if no, it doesn't serve you anymore, be gracious to let it go. That is the entire concept of the silent to-do list. The moment you let go, you check off an item of that list, you will feel your mental burden coming off. So friends, definitely read Goodbye Things by Fumio Sasaki. Go through the silent list. Do let me know your experiences with these things, with these items. How do you declutter them? I will also share with you some minimalism games which I have personally tried and they have worked for me. But that is in the next video. Till such time, please comment, like, subscribe, share the drill, and I shall be back with the next one. Bye-bye.